found your cell phone. You were looking for it earlier. I'd like to share a really short testimony. You're more than welcome to come forward and share a short testimony. It's sort of be like Tommy. It's supposed to be 2 minutes and it's like 15 seconds.
That's okay.
That's all right. If you want to do a short testimony, you're more than welcome to come forward and to share how God has grown your faith this year. Anybody like to? As you know, when difficult things happen in different cities, when they had a terrorist attack in Boston, the city rallied together and they called it Boston Strong. Remember that? Boston Strong. We're going to be all in this together. And that phrase has been used, you know, Houston Strong, as you know, the hurricane went through. When they had a mass shooting in Texas at high school, if you name a high school, but, you know, we're strong together. Having faith and confidence in God, we can have a similar spirit. We can be Alhambra strong, Charles Lawson's wife. We're Alhambra strong. Carolyn talked about her struggles with her mother. We'd be Alhambra strong. Dante was diagnosed with cancer. He's down in Tijuana right now. We'll pull together. We're Alhambra strong. The Addis family, last week, lost their father, their husband, our friend. We're Alhambra strong. That strength that we call Alhambra strong is because we are Jesus strong. Because faith to go is grounded in faith in Jesus. As Prakash said, no matter where we go, no matter what we do, we have Jesus living within us. And we can ask him to do. There's nothing so small, there's nothing so trivial, there's nothing so huge that Jesus does not have a plan for you to go forward with. It could be something as simple as, what should I watch on television? It could be something so minute as, what should I eat that's in the refrigerator? Or it could be so huge and momentous as, what should I do with my life's career? What should I do in my parenting right now with my child? God wants to have sovereignty over all of your life. He wants to have input on every aspect of your life. He wants you to have faith and confidence in him, no matter what the situation might be. Sunny Sundays or rainy Mondays. So today we are celebrating an emblem, a service that typifies and broadly and proudly proclaims that faith in Christ. When we have communion services, when we take that bread and we drink that juice, we are saying once again to everyone who observes us and the audience of one that is watching us, that we have faith in you. When we eat that bread, we are saying, I have faith in you. When we drink that wine, we say, I have faith in you, in your death on the cross, in your resurrection, and eternal life. In a little while, we'll be washing each other's feet. In that very same way, we are saying, I have faith in you that I will humbly serve my fellow man the way you have asked me to do. So as we celebrate this words of humility and the Lord's Supper, it is a very appropriate way as we conclude our Faith to Go series. Next year we will embark on a different journey, but we don't want to ever forget the faith journey that we have embarked on in 2018. And we'll just want to build on that. So as the elders come forward, and Jesus Lord leads us in some music, I want to ask you to come forward down the middle aisle, and the elders will serve you, and then return to your seats and wait until the elders serve you. If you are not able to come forward, there will be an elder who will come and bring the emblems to you. And we want everyone to participate. You don't have to be a Seventh-day Adventist to participate in the ordinance of Lord's the purpose, you do need to be convicted, committed follower of Jesus.